Welcome to this next session of Harbour and Engineering. So let us begin with this new topic of the chapter, that is locks or lock gates. So first of all, this is an image representing the lock details. Now the word lock can be used, lock gate can be used, or gate can be used, all indicating the same meaning, that is the gates which are provided for retaining water. So this is the cross section of lock passage, and this is the plan or top view. So first of all, talking about the plan, that is the top view of a typical lock. Now this is a passage which has been shown, which is connecting the harbor portion with the lock. Plan, this is showing, that is lock chamber, which has been written, is a passage which is connecting the harbor portion with the lock. There can be two situations, passage can be provided, or there can be directly arrangement of a single gate which will retain the water. So both scenarios can exist, that is existence of a passage for movement. It is basically passage is needed where there is need of a deep draft, that is if a heavy tonnage ship is entering the dock, it needs a certain amount of water depth which has to be maintained throughout its movement. Now if only one gate is provided, then abruptly the depth will change, and in the dock I cannot directly increase that much amount of water depth abruptly. So a passage is provided for a sort of giving a easier movement from the harbor to the dock portion where there is need of deep water, deep draft for heavy ship. So basically gate floor, that is the bottommost level, that is the floor of the passage. So basically gate floor indicates the floor or the platform of the passage on which the water will be existing, that is the depth of water, and over through that passage the movement will take place. So basically floor, that is even if we talk generally in general sense in buildings, the floor, that is the platform on which movement will take place, that is same for passage. Gate has been shown here. This is the first gate, this is the second gate. So this is the portion which is handling the harbor and the lock chamber or passage, that is on one side is the water of harbor, here will be the water of the passage or chamber, and next gate again will have on one side the water for passage or chamber, and on the other side it will have dock. We will be learning about this procedure in the upcoming points, but basically the first gate is separating, that is this is the lower pull gate, this is the upper pull gate. The lower pull gate is separating the harbor and the passage, and the upper pull gate is separating the passage and the dock itself. So these are the two gates. Lock chamber is the passage. Seal level indicates the bottommost level of the gate. So seal, we know, is basically related to windows, which indicates the bottommost level. So seal level for gate is the bottommost level of the lock gate itself. And these two are specifically the boundaries or the walls of the passage. So this is the view with labels of typical lock. Next, this is the cross section. Here as you can see, there is an inverted arc floor, that is for the this gate floor which has been shown will have an inverted shape. The reason being to take into account the thrust of the water. So basically to counteract the uplift force of the water, instead of providing the straight line, this curvature is provided to increase the thrust. Talking in brief regarding these locks or gates or lock gates. Lock is a chamber with open ends, generally rectangular in plan, for hydraulic transfer of ship from one pool to another at different elevation. So the water level will be different in the three segments, that is the harbor portion, the passage itself, and the dock itself. So basically, as the water level existing is different, to make sure that there is a smooth transfer of ship from harbor to passage to dock, basically this passage or lock chamber is provided, which is generally rectangular in plan and for transfer of ship. It provides access to dock, that is basically it is for the movement, smooth movement of ship from harbor to dock. Lock is comprised of a chamber enclosed by walls on its each side. So basically, on both the sides, the quay walls are constructed, that is, they might be retaining earth, and both the side is basically comprised of these walls, which are ultimately forming the chamber. In the bottom is the gate, that is the flooring, and on both the sides will be the quay wall forming a chamber. And opening of lock chamber are so arranged that they can be closed by means of gates. So basically, the chamber is so arranged that on both the sides, one is the lower pull gate, one is the upper pull gate. So on both the sides, lock gate is existing, and they are arranged such that it can be kept as fully enclosed as and when the need is arising. Gate can be closed against the sill raised 60 cm above the gate floor. So basically, sill level, that is the bottommost level of gate, and next is the gate floor, that is the bottommost level of the passage. So there can be level difference of 60 cm between the sill level of gate and the flooring. In order to fill or make the lock empty, sluice ways are formed in the side walls. So basically, as we have discussed, that on both the sides there will be walls. So through that walls, the sluice ways can be provided, which will carry the water so that the emptying operation, that is the pumping out operation from the dock, can be carried out in case of dry dock. Lock is paved at the bottom by an inverted arch flooring to resist the upward water pressure when the lock level is low. So this point, as we have already seen, that is the thrust will be provided. So due to that inverted arch, it will resist the forces, the upward water pressure, in a better manner as compared to the straight line. Next, the gates of dry dock are similar to that of wet docks. There is only difference is that in case of dry dock, the gates are used to exclude water, that is to make sure that the water does not enter into the dock. In case of wet dock, the gates are for retaining water, that is the water inside the dock remains at a certain level with reference to the harbor portion, which is having the water inside the dock, as we have already seen, is one which does not have sort of more amount of sediments. So the non-turbid water can be used inside, and also the level difference with reference to the water outside the lock gate, that is with respect to harbor, can be maintained at different elevations. Locks are extremely useful device to maintain the continuity of navigation between two water bodies at different elevation. So whenever if we are entering from harbor to lock through the passage, there will be variation in water level amongst them. This harbor will be having a different water level, the passage in the center will be having a different water level, and the dock itself will be having a different water level. So when this movement is needed at different water level elevations, at that time these lock gates are extremely useful. Generally, the lock gates are made up of timber or iron, but mostly iron is used more than timber. Made in pairs, that is in two numbers. Gates are provided at upper and lower end of lock chamber, as we have already seen. Again, we will be seeing this point in an upcoming theory in this session itself. The types of gate provided are basically these four types. This is also an important question regarding the types of lock gates. So we'll be seeing one by one all these four various types of lock gates. First is the mitre gate. So basically, this is the top view. This is the sea side, and this is the harbor side, the dock side. This black three thick lines, the thick lines on both the sides, indicate that curvature. When the gates will be opened, they will be resting in this curvature. This is indicating the closed state. The gates are in contact with each other. This curvature, which has been shown, it is that recess or space which is provided, in which the gate will rest when they are open. So when they are open, they will rest in these hatches which have been shown. This is indicating the closed state, where they are in contact with each other and retaining the water. So this consists of two leaves of equal size, that is, if you see the image, sort of represents a leaf being in contact with each other. So consist of two leaves which are of equal size, which turn about the vertical axis in a recess in the opposite lock wall. So they turn about the vertical axis, and the recess or gap space is provided, the edges in which they will rest when they are open. When closed, the two leaves miter and support each other. That is, they remain in contact with each other and supporting one another, and sort of they represent the shape of a leaf. Next, this is the view for the miter gate. So we can see the two leaves, they are in contact with each other and they will be retaining the water. Next is the sector gate. So it has two views, that is the closed view and the open view. Here a sort of the recess or sort of gap or space is provided, which has been labeled as gate chamber, in which this gate will rest when it is open. So as we can see that when this will move inside, this is the view for open state. So this both the portion will go inside this empty space or area which has been provided. So here the movement of water has been shown. It will be retaining water in the closed state and will allow the movement of water and the ship in the open state. So new thing here is that this is a CC construction. So specifically a structure is constructed which will house that gate. We will be having the gate inside it and will be providing the protection to the gate. So this is the closed view and this point will go inside, creating in this empty space which will be the open state. Either horizontally or vertically framed, we have seen the top view, that is the plan in the previous image. Closure of chamber is done by two gates mounted in opposition, so they abut when closed. That is, they come in contact with each other and support each other when they are closed at the time of retaining water. So this is the view for the sector gate. This is the closed state, this is the open state. So this is the construction, that is the CC construction, inside which the gate when opened will be housed. And this is the closed state when they are in contact with each other, supporting each other. Next is the rolling gate. So here basically, as the word rolling has been used, so the rollers will be provided. The dashed portion indicates that state in which the gate will be opened and will allow the movement of water or ship. So these are the rollers which are provided, and basically when, say for example, if two gates are existing, when they both are placed adjacent to each other, then this space will be empty. So the movement of water will be allowed and the movement of ship will be allowed. Also there can be recess or gap in the wall itself can be provided, and the rollers can be pushed inside the wall as well. So gap or space can be provided in the wall which are on both the sides, and the rollers can be pushed inside those walls, inside that gap, at the time of allowing movement of water or ship, and then again while closing they can be sort of immersed outside the wall or the recess. So this is basically the front view, and as I told, the dashed line indicates that point when the gates are open, and closed line indicates that they are fully along the width of the passage and they are retaining the water. That is the closed edge of the gate. At bottom is the top view. Again here the dashed line indicates the point or the stage when the gates are open, that is allowing the movement, and the solid line indicates the stage when they are retaining the water, that is the closed stage of the gate. So the front view and the top view, rollers are provided. So basically this is the functioning of the rolling gate. Again repeating, the gap or recess can exist in the walls where these gates can be pushed inside the wall. Consists of steel frame which operates on a flanged wheels running on tracks embedded in log floor. So basically tracks are embedded in the log floor, that is in the bottommost point of, that is with reference to the flooring. Steel frame will exist and it will be running on the tracks. So the steel constructed gates will be running on the tracks embedded with the floor. In open position, gate is housed in the recessing wall, that is as I told, in the gap. Log chamber is closed by rolling gates on its track out of the recess. So when we want to retain the water, they will be removed out of that recess and they will be sort of moved on the tracks across the width. Next is the vertical lift gate. So here, as the word is vertical lift, so the gate is vertically lifted when it is to be opened, and when it is to be closed, it is given a free fall up to the bottom. So vertical lift, here the movement will take place in the vertical direction. when we want it in upper state, we will be sort of lifting the gate as a whole, and when we want to close the passage, it will be immersed into the water up to the seabed, up to the flooring, so it will be retaining the water. So basically the lift type gate, vertical lift type gate, are hung from frame spanning the lock chamber by means of chain or wire ropes. So as seen, this is the view for the vertical lift gate. So they can be hung by chain or wire or rope, that is the connection. This is showing the open state, that is when they are vertically lifted above and allowing the movement of water or ship. And when needed, they will move up to the flooring, that is up to the bottommost portion. So this is the view for the vertical lift type gate. Next is the operation of lock gates. Now this is the lower gate and the upper gate, which we have seen in the beginning figure of this session itself. So we will be learning in this point as to how is the movement of the ship taking place from harbor to the dock. So the two gates, first the lower gate is separating the lower pool level, that is the harbor water, with the passage, and the upper gate is separating the passage or the lock chamber water level with the upper pool, that is the water level in dock. Now water level in lock chamber or in the dock can be existing or it can be empty. There can be both the situations. So what happens is that here, first of all, we are understanding as to how is the ship entering from the lower pool, that is harbor, to the upper pool, that is the dock, which can be wet dock or dry dock. So first of all, these gates, that is the lower gate and upper gate, both are closed. Firstly, when the ship has entered, the lower gate will be open. So the water from harbor will enter into the lock chamber of the passage. It will enter up to that point when the water level between the lower pool level, that is the harbor, and the lock chamber or passage becomes equal. So up to, that is the simple law of gravity. So that will, the movement will take place up to the point till which the water level becomes same. Then the ship will be allowed to move from the lower pool, that is harbor water, to the lock chamber or passage, and after entering the passage, the lower gate will be closed. Next, the upper gate will be opened, so the water from the lock chamber or the passage will enter the upper pool or the dock. Repeating again, the water inside the passage or the dock can be empty or it can be consisting of some level of water. So basically, the movement of water will take place between the passage and the dock up to that point when the water level becomes equal. So again, that is the simple gravity law. So the water level will get same in the two portion, that is passage and the dock. Then again, after the water has become of same level, the ship or vessel will be allowed to move from the passage towards the dock. And after entering the dock, the upper gate will be closed, it will be retaining the water. So this is how the movement takes place. And when the ship is supposed to leave the dock, then the reverse phenomena will take place. That is, first of all, the upper gate is open. Water from the dock or the upper pool will enter the lock chamber or passage up to the point where the water level becomes same. Then the ship will be allowed to move from dock or upper pool to the lock chamber or passage. Then upper gate will be closed. Then lower gate will be opened, where the water will move from lock chamber or the passage to the lower pool of the harbor. Again, the water will move up to the point where the water level becomes same. Then after the water level has become same or similar in both these points, the ship will make movement from the lock chamber or passage towards the lower pool or the harbor portion, and after that the lower gate will be closed. So lastly, the operation which we have already seen in the previous image has been mentioned here in the theoretical form. For upstream lockage, the vessel is admitted into the lock chamber through the lower or downstream opening, that is the lower gate is open, for allowing the movement into the lock chamber from the lower pool. Then lower gate is closed and the water level in the lock is equalized corresponding to the upstream or upper pool. So the lower gate is closed, and then the water level is equalized, that is same level is being made between the lock chamber or the passage and the upper pull or the dock. When this process is accomplished, the vessel is admitted in the dock by opening of the upper gate. That is, ship is made to move into the dock and then the upper gate is closed. If the vessel has to move downstream, that is, it has to move towards the harbor after the completion of the operation, the reverse operation, as I already explained in the last image, is been carried out. So this is the end of chapter number 5, that is docks and locks. From the next session, we will be beginning with a new chapter, that is chapter number 6, port amenities and navigational aids.